Ryan will be up there giving evidence against you. If you can't prove that he's lying...
They'll always take the word of a cop's against a hooker's. Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Yes. You won't come out of it looking very pretty. I suggest that you plead guilty.
Like hell I will.
Then you can apply for a reduced sentence. Maybe even get off with a fine.
No way, you bastard. I know what you want. If I win, you and your mate Stanfield and Ryan will be in real trouble.
If you lose, you'll be in real trouble.
But I am not guilty. I was bloody well framed, and I'm getting up and I'm saying so, and you can tell that to your bloody precious Stanfield. Stupid bastard, telling me to take it lying down. Well, he can shove it.
Now, hang on, what did he say? Maybe you should take his advice.
You gotta be kidding me. I wouldn't take his advice if I were drowning and he was telling me how to float.
He might go against it, and then where would she be?
I tell you where I'd bloody be, stuck in here for God knows how long.
Yeah, but what if it goes okay? You might just cop a fine.
Yeah, you'd have plenty of money to pay that with the money from the dispatch.
Girls, 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 I have never been mixed up with drugs, and I don't want it on the record. All they've ever copped me for was soliciting.
I do remember a little something about receiving stolen goods.
Oh, yeah, okay, once. But nothing to do with drugs. Once the cops think you're mixed up with that, you've got them on your back for life. Now, I want my slate wiped clean of this one.
Well, fair enough, but I don't like your chances.
Like hell. I'm not giving in that easy.
Bit late. Some of the customers have been asking after you.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Greg. Another run-in with that bloody sister-in-law of mine.
Well, things not too hot in the home front, eh?
No. I don't know how much longer I can stomach it.
Well, I'd wind up moving here. Got plenty of room. I reckon you and I'd get on real well.
I don't reckon I could afford it, Greg. Take most of me pay.
Well, I wasn't going to take it out of your wages, love.
Oh, he ain't half a naughty boy, ain't he, Mr. Palmer? I don't know what I'm going to do with him.
Reckon I could work that one out for her. Hey, Fred.
Burns I got were pretty minor. Making the most of my time off work.
Bought you a casserole. Thought you'd be too weak to cook.
Oh, it's terrific. Is it still hot?
Warm anyway. I had no idea you lived so far out.
Oh, it's great. I could eat a horse. Come on up.
Okay. The watchdog's gone for a biscuit. Time for a smoko.
I think even a fag would taste rotten at the moment.
Oh, have one of mine. They always taste better when they're someone else's.
Made up your mind what you're going to do, Helen?
I don't see what the hell I can do.
You still think the cop that searched your place planted the dope himself?
Well, what do you think? He's going to work for one of Harry Stanfield's companies, isn't he? A nice cushy job in there?
Try telling the judge that.
Oh, it's just not fair.
Well, when's life ever been fair to us?
Hey, you know, there could be another good article in this.
How do you mean?
I could write a follow-up to the last one I did on you, giving all the details of the shady goings-on. Show everyone the situation stinks to high heaven.
Who'd believe us?
Once it's in print, it could cause some embarrassment in the right places.
It's better than sitting around doing nothing.
Right. Come on, B, get out your pen and paper. You tell the world how this good girl's been done wrong.
Good girl? God, they're never going to believe that.
There you go, Mr. Palmer.
I don't know about you, Phil, but I would.
Only if she asks nicely, of course.
Oh, yeah. Listen, you travelling salesmen are supposed to see a fair amount of spare stuff, aren't you? Wouldn't be many more as good as that getting around, would they?
I've been trying to pinch her off you. Get her to come with me on a trip.
Hey, mate, hands on. She works for me, all right?
You know, she could earn herself a nice bonus.
She'd come at a bit of special overtime.
You reckon you could find her something to do after hours, is that good?
Yeah, I reckon I could find her something to do, yeah.
How are you, Phil?
Well, after the other night, what do you reckon?
Do you still want me to come on that trip with you?
Yeah, sure. But I didn't think you wanted to.
Oh, I could change my mind, couldn't I?
Well, I'll make it worth your while. Give you a real good time.
All right. You're on. When do we leave?
Tonight. Can you be ready in time?
Sure.
All right. But you have it set.
Don't say anything to Greg about this, all right? I'm thinking of chucking this job in anyway. I'm sick to death of it.
You can do better for yourself. A girl like you.
On the house.
Till tonight.
Tonight.
You could have at least given me a week's notice, Chrissy. Give me a chance to find somebody to take the place.
Sorry. Something came up real sudden.
Sure we're going to miss you around here. You sure do brighten up the view. A lot of the regulars are going to miss you too.
Oh, they'll survive.
Listen, why don't you change your mind and stick around? After all, we haven't really got to know each other yet, have we?
No. Don't look like we ever will either, does it? Now, can I have my money? I want to get back to Elizabeth.
You realise you're not entitled to any holiday pay, just being casual.
Yeah, I know. Just give me what I've earned.
Sign for it in the book. Just remember, if you ever need a room for the night, this place is residential and very hospitable.
Yeah, well, I'm going away for a while. I'll see how things are when I come back. If I come back. See ya.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes. Chief Inspector Finlay and Detective Sergeant Lovell.
B11 branch?
That's right. Internal investigation.
All right. I've heard of you. What can I do to help?
We'd like to see Helen Smart.
She suddenly seems to be getting a lot of attention.
We have reason to believe she may be able to help us with an investigation. Can we see her now? We don't have a lot of time.
Oh, yes, of course. I'll get an officer to take you to the interview room. I'll fetch the prisoner.
Thank you.
Hey, I like it. I know you've only just started, but what you've written to now is great.
Yeah, I'm not so sure. It doesn't hit the bars, it's hard enough. The point I am trying to get across is just because some cop says you did it, you mustn't. And no one gives a damn about your side of it.
Yeah. Could be a year out of my life, you know, B, for something that I didn't even do. And then I'll never be free of it. The cops will see to that. Like I said to the girls, once they bust you on a drug charge, they're with you for life.
Yeah. Well, that's what's got to come across in this. I just hope I made it strong enough.
Don't know what makes them think you're a writer, Smith.
I don't care what they think of me, Mrs. Powell, just as long as I keep getting published.
Oh, well, there'll always be scandal rags to print muck.
Muck? Crooked cops planting dope in her house, harassing her, having her stuck in here so she can be shoved around like dirt. Now, that's muck. And she deserves every cent of that $5,000.
Get to work. Not you, Smart. You're wanted.
Of course I am, by hundreds of men. But I've got a feeling that's not what you're getting at.
You're already halfway to solitary. What's it going to be?
All right. Who wants me?
You'll find that out in the interview room. Move it.
Try to get down everything she says.
Oh, what's this? Not another bloody interrogation.
I'm Chief Inspector Finlay, Miss Smart. This is Detective Sergeant Lovell.
So?
were investigating your claim that hashish was planted in your flat by a member of the force.
I never said that. I admitted that a friend who used the flat could have left it there.
Please, sit down, Miss Smart. I don't want you to feel intimidated.